everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and look how much cleaner we all are. Look at... round of laundry is all it took. I'm looking as... clean as ever. So is Veronica, and Eddie, I can't wash him. He's very susceptible to water. You know, being a robot and all. We're still here in Mick and Ralph's with another episode of Fallout New Vegas. I am looking for Mick. Presently. I can't seem to find him. Mick, where'd you go, man? I don't want to just rummage through all your stuff, but I'm trying to... Oh, you're right here.
Welcome back.
So there's actually a second little bit of the shop that you can get access to, and all it takes is choosing the right dialogue choice when you talk to Mick and passing a speech test. So, you will say, do you have any special items for sale?
Why? Do you work for one of the casinos?
And that's him being very cautious because the casino families on the strip, usually they kind of just want to take over everything, including Freeside. So the last thing Mick wants to do is supply weapons for them. So you'll say no.
In that case, yes I do. Follow me.
Aw yeah, thanks dude. So he'll lead us down to his secret compartment of stuff. It's friggin' awesome. I'm so psyched. Show me the way, man. It's right over by his workstation. Check this out. Oh my god. There's just like a secret room.
Like I always say.
Oh, I love it. And really, the only reason I wanted to come in here, there's not really any like extra weapons that I want personally. Really, all he gives you... God, friggin'... grenade machine gun. That is so crazy, dude. You know, things like that, and like there's like throwing knives and stuff you can get. All the apparel is still the same and all that. Really, the only reason I wanted this was that I could get some grenades. So, some 40mm grenades. You can get the 25mm grenades as well. Those would be the grenades that power the grenade machine gun. But, ooh, nope. Except, there we go. But I'm just not arsing myself with it. Just not bothering. Because the grenade machine gun, I mean, like, it's okay. Like, it's a good weapon. It's just a little bit too much too fast, you know? It's like company growth. It's got to be very gradual. But we are going to explore more of Freeside. So, unfortunately, viewer, there's going to be a significant lack of grenade machine guns in this video. So if you were looking forward to that, you can just go ahead and unsubscribe right now. Because it's not happening in this video. But on the bright side, we're going to go into this where like this big fort place here. This brick wall. We're going into here. Because there's lots of factions that are represented here in Freeside. Because a lot of people want to take control of Freeside so that they can move in as close to the strip as possible. You know, in hopes of building this place up to being something good. Rather than, you know, just a ghetto. But this is the old Mormon fort. And the old Mormon fort is home to a Followers of the Apocalypse settlement, which is super cool.
Hey.
This is their head guard, Beatrix Russell. She's a ghoul.
Howdy.
Hey girl, what's up?
I've been around a while. Currently working for the Followers as a gun for hire, but it's getting rather dull. Aside from protecting them from the occasional thug looking to intercept supply shipments, there isn't much to do around here. The one researcher I liked, who I could chat up about liquor, got transferred. And the rest of the docs are pretty uptight about my kind of fun.
Oh, that's no fun. What are you doing with the Followers?
I joined up looking for a decent paying job. Granted, the pay's all right, but they won't let me kick back and slog a brew at the end of the day. They're worried the filthy drunkies in detox seeing me drink will cause an immediate relapse. I say their rehab effort here is just a revolving door.
Ooh. Yikes. I wouldn't say the program here is a revolving door. It's more the fact that the immediate outside world beyond these walls of the old Mormon fort is just poverty and drinking and sex. So, you know, that's probably a big issue.
I've been around long enough to observe the patterns of human behavior. Physical and mental anguish are especially exciting to explore.
Ooh, that's sadistic.
Hey, Who doesn't enjoy a little pinch and squeal every once in a while?
Okay. Alright, well, Beatrix, I'll see you later. She's clearly unfulfilled at her current job. So, I don't know, let's keep that in mind. You know, the thing you have to keep in mind with this game is that every person who, like, talks about something, usually what they're talking about will tie into a quest somehow. You know, just like that guitar guy that we saw a few episodes ago. Something with him is probably going to be concerning a quest. And Beatrix being unfulfilled at her current job might mean that she's going somewhere else. But for now, we are going to talk to this fine young lady here, Julie Farkas. She's actually one of my favorite characters in this game.
What's up?
Are you here to drop off medical supplies? Leave them with the rest in the middle of the courtyard.
Okay. Yeah, so she's sort of like the leader of the followers in this area. She's the one that does all the plans. What is this place?
The old Mormon fort serves as the regional hub for the followers of the Apocalypse. I am the administrator for this region.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah. So tell me, who exactly are the followers of the Apocalypse? You know, we had that other guy, like, Ignatio, sort of tell us, but he was very vague.
We arose from the boneyards of Adidim years ago. Since then, we have made it our mission to rebuild the wasteland and re-educate its inhabitants. We hope to forge a brave new world free of war and poverty by sharing knowledge and resources. Our primary goal is the free exchange of ideas.
That's a philosophy I can get behind. Okay. What do you do here?
The followers of the Apocalypse aren't just interested in research. We care for our fellow man and do everything we can to help humanity. Here in Freeside, we provide food and medical services for those in need. We also have organized reconstruction efforts. With the help of Bill Ronte, we were able to install a water pump just west of here, but the Kings quickly took control of the pump.
Oh, geez. Well, that's really cool. You guys are like a friggin' response team in emergencies. That's awesome. I think that's a very noble goal to have. Especially in a world like this, you know, the aftermath of war where everyone is so selfish and just trying to get by. Which is rightfully so. It's kind of nice that there's like a group of scientists banding together to really try to make things better in the long term. That's cool. Anyway, you need medical supplies?
Rates of injury and illness in Freeside are very high. Supplies don't last long.
Okay, well what do you need?
Medex, Radaway, and Fixer are Freeside essentials. I can't pay you for any supplies you bring in, but I could discount the charge for our services.
Well, so she wants us to go and pick up some stuff, and you can do it two different ways from here. You can accept her deal and just go out and find, like, you know, all these medical supplies and bring them to her. Or you can strike up a deal with third-party suppliers so that they have a steady supply of chems and medical supplies rather than just whatever I grab. I'm gonna go with the latter, just because, you picture it in your head and it just makes more sense to have a steady supply. So we'll see what happens.
So far, the Crimson Caravan won't cut us a deal. If you can convince them or some other merchant to work with us, I'll discount supplies to you.
Okay. Which merchants might be willing to make a deal?
You might ask around at Mick and Ralph's, or go see the Garretts, though I suspect they're too busy poisoning Freeside to help it out.
All right, cool, that sounds good.
Just come see me when you've got some supplies to turn in.
Okay. So you can talk about other things here. Medical supplies to drop off. Oh, okay, so you can still do the drop off method. Okay, so you can still do it both ways, leading up to the conclusion. Yeah, things are pretty rough here, man. Dude's kids eating rats outside.
Mess. Freeside townies are constantly picking fights with NCR civilians. Thugs and thieves are always looking for a victim, and the local families are just sitting back making caps on the mess. Freeside is in dire need, but no one has been man enough to step up. The followers can only do so much to stem the tide.
Okay, is there anything I can do?
There is always something needing done. A few souls here in Freeside could be great assets to the community if they'd kick their addictions. We need a regular supply of medicine organized, but the Crimson Caravan wants too many caps for what we need. Lastly, tensions between the townies and NCR tourists have been going downhill fast lately. A lot of innocent people will get hurt if things blow up.
Ooh, boy. All right. So let's help out some addicts.
Yes, old Bill Ronte and Jacob Hoff. They're not going to kick their habits on their own.
Okay, tell me about Bill Ronte.
Old Bill Ronte is an exceptionally skilled machinist. He could fix the problems we've been having with Freeside's water pump, if he sobered up.
Okay, so we have an alcoholic engineer. Tell me about Jacob.
The Garretts hooked Jacob on chems when he was working for them. Ironic, since he used to homebrew detox chems. He's a natural chemist.
Okay, alright, so we have an alcoholic engineer and a chemist who has now gotten hooked on chems. Good lord, I'll see what I can do to help them. Alright, we'll exit this for now. Julie still does have a lot more to say, but we'll take this one step at a time, because if you go through all of Julie's dialogue from beginning to end, you end up with like three different quests on the go. So we'll take it in pieces so that we don't get overwhelmed too quickly. We will we'll go to our quest screen just to make sure we have the right one. Yeah, see, I don't have the right one. High times. There we go. So we gotta help out two dudes kick their addictions so that they can help Freeside for the better. One will help out with the water pump situation, and the other one will continue to start making detox chems again, which will help other people who are fighting relapse, which is super neat. We're gonna go in here. I always like this quest, High Times, because it's like, you know, all the other quests in the game up until now, oh no, look at them, oh, what a bum. Ugh.
Yep.
Every other quest in this game is always like, oh man, help me dispatch these people. Help me get revenge for this, revenge for that. Avenge this. You know, kill this person. Go and teach this person a lesson. Free this person. Rescue this person. But this one, it's like, you're rescuing them, but not with guns. You know, you're helping everyday people, and I think that's super cool. Anyway. Jacob!
You have chems, buddy? I could really use a fix.
Troy Baker, you look pretty bad, dude. Troy Baker, you've never looked worse. You should probably stop using chems.
Why stop? I feel great. No worries. My guy will be here soon enough. Just wait.
No. Who's supplying you?
If I had two caps to scrape together, I'd buy the materials to make my own. My damn hands won't stop shaking. This guy named Dixon. Something about him seems sketchy, but I can't stop now. Last time I stopped, I felt like I was gonna turn inside out. At this point, I'm mostly buying his stuff just so I don't feel sick. Speaking of which, do you have any spare caps?
Dude, stop. No, dude, stop. Stop bumming, alright? Don't go and do that, alright? Just don't, okay? Good lord. So anyway, a guy named Dixon has been supplying him with his chems. This guy over here. This asshole. Who's also voiced by Troy Baker.
Looking for a fix, man? I got what you need.
Okay, do you know anything about Bill or Jacob?
Yeah, man. Those cats are out of their domes, addicted to my shit. They can't get enough. Pretty hilarious to watch.
Oh, dude, that is messed up. Are you trying to kill your customers?
Those fools are from NCR. I love seeing those squatters in agony.
Oh, dude.
We were doing just fine before those shits came here and made a mess of things. We don't need NCR eggheads wandering around confusing things.
It's not confusing things, they're trying to make things better. You know, for better or worse. Yeah, I need you to stop supplying these two dudes. Trying to help out Julie.
Really? Ah, you're such a saint. You know what? I might be willing to stop if there's something in it for me.
Something in it for you? Huh, maybe I'll make up a lie about you with my speech check. this is a good one. So the NCR is supplying you with cheap chems? To keep Freeside down. Really, is that what's happening?
Wait, man, you can't go around saying shit like that. Okay, I get your point. You won't have to worry about me supplying those two anymore.
Good. Good. Perfect. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Okay, actually, you know what? He might have some stuff on him. Let's see. Dixon's jet. Yeah, see, this is the stuff that I got a character addicted to, but then I killed Dixon, so I couldn't kick my addiction because I couldn't get it anymore because he was dead. Oh god, sorry about that, guys. I got a little pop-up there that completely screwed over everything. It ruined everything. Anyway, we're just gonna finish picking up this stuff from Dixon. Friggin' AVG, man, little pop-up, tune up your PC. It's like, piss off. You already eat up enough of my system RAM. Screw off. I just keep you so that you can, like, warn me with a pop-up, like, 1 in 1,000 times. When there actually is a virus about to escape into my PC. So stupid, man. Some companies, dude, they make a killing off of those antivirus things, you know? Absolutely ridiculous. Or wait, what am I doing? I have to go back to Bill Ronte and tell him that I got Dixon to take early retirement. Yeah, that's what happened. That's the story I'm sticking with. Dixon retired happily with all of his drug money. He was getting so stressed out from his work, he almost lost his head over it.
That is one. So you're back.
No, don't comment on my robot. I took care of your dealer.
What? I need a fix now.
No, dude, I want to help you get well, Jacob.
Fine. If you really care so much, then give me some shots of Fixer to calm down these shakes. I'm gonna need at least 10 shots to get me through the week.
No, I'm gonna stop you there. Dang it! Darn it! Dang it! What? Science and speech? Both have to be at 50? Well, not both, either or. But I think I have some programmer's digest, so I should be okay. Am I? Yeah!
So you're back.
I'm back, dude. Yeah, I've got the detox chems you need. Boom. Sorry, I kind of skipped through that dialogue really quickly right there. Basically, what the science check did was, originally he wanted 10 doses of Fixer, but essentially we used our fabulous, you know, genius mind in the sciences to tell him that he actually only needed, like, a couple doses of Fixer and, like, some other chem. And, like, we were able to, like, mix them together to get the same effect. Ah, it's great. It's great. Jacob didn't think of it, but it's because he clearly doesn't have a science skill of 50. Just goes to prove that I'm way better than him once I read a book. You know, you just pick up a book, just goes to...
Thirsty? Horny? The Atomic Wrangler has you covered.
Excuse me?
You want someone dead.
Well, I mean, I'm not any of those three things, but, you know, I'll keep that in mind. I don't want someone really dead. Good lord. The Silver Rush. You always hear that on the radio in this game. Silver Rush. Feel the heat of a... Oh, I can't even remember what it was. Ah, of something like a plasma blaster. Something like that. Warm laser in your hands. I don't know. There's some radio ad about it. Bill Ronte! Wow, buddy.
Come on, man. I'm dying here.
Wow. You, Alright, Julie sent me to sober you up.
Julie? I love Julie. She's such a nice lady.
I know.
One time I was working on the water pump, and she came over, put her hand on my shoulder, and told me I was doing a great job. Great job, she says. I just choked up and didn't say nothing. Compliments are so rare these days.
I'm sure that's very true. That's still a very creepy way of addressing it. Anyway, you won't be seeing Dixon anymore. He's on vacation.
What the hell? Why? I need alcohol, man.
No, dude, you don't need
I'm
it.
I'm gonna die if I don't get a drink.
No, you gotta kick the habit, dude.
The only way you can help me now is a load of detox chems.
No. What do you need?
At least a couple of doses of Fixer, a bottle of whiskey, and Radaway. I can take doses of Fixer and Radaway to gradually flush my system over time while drinking decreasing shots of diluted whiskey. This shit better be worth it, man.
Good lord. Oh no, I need science again! Oh no! One sec. Oh god. Programmer. Oh, crap. I ate some pinion nuts. They were delicious.
Come on, man. I'm dying here.
Dude, you're not dying. You're fine. All right. Regulating decreasing doses of booze with a couple shots of Fixer should do it. Yeah.
Man, you're one hell of an egghead. If you think it'll work, I'll give it a shot.
Yeah. Do it. Okay, cool. So let's see. Oh, wait. Oh, no. That thing just told us what we needed. Okay, let's see. Collect 2 doses of Fixer and a bottle of whiskey for Bill. Okay, I think I have the whiskey. Might not have the Fixer. Because I usually just sell off Fixer. Okay, I have one thing of Fixer. But I need 2. Oh, come on, I have it backwards. I have 2 whiskeys and 1 Fixer. Oh, boy, okay. Frig. Okay, I'm gonna have to do some fast traveling. Crap. Come on. Come on, man. I'll go to Novak. I remember that doctor girl. Here, the one with, like, the blood all over her shirt. Maybe she has some fixer. Let's see. It's just a merchant. Where's the doctor? Oh, she's over here. I recognize these two underpaid, skeptical mercenaries anywhere. One of them has a baseball cap and the other guy's old. Hey, Dr. Ada Strauss.
What can I do for you?
Or Strauss, whatever it is. I'm not hurt. I need medical supplies.
Yeah, and I need sterile medical supplies. But let's see what I have with me.
Well, that doesn't inspire a lot of confidence. I'll take your fixer, though. Wait, why do you have energy cells? What the? Why are you selling weapons? You're a doctor. Whoa. Ooh, look at all this stuff. Take that stim pack. Because why the heck not? Take some doctor's bags.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Yep, thank you. I'll just teleport away from you now. Hope you don't mind. I'm just gonna teleport on over to the Freeside Gate. Like the son of bitch I am. Perfect. Alright, now we gotta walk all through this again. It'd be nicer if there were a lot more fast travel points within Freeside. Just because the place is so big, it can be a pain to travel between at times. Just because, like, I gotta walk through all this again. Ugh. There are markers over there. That blue door. This place can be very confusing to traverse at first as well, so keep that in mind. If you're playing alongside me, but you're not watching the footage, like, verbatim, you might get lost a few times, you know, running through here. It just comes to you with time, really. The signs help as well, but I find it's easier to find the signs at night. So also keep that in mind. You might have a better time exploring this place when it's nighttime rather than daytime. Hey, boy.
Come on, man, I'm dying here.
Yeah, you're not dying. You're fine. All right, I've got what you asked for.
I felt like I was dying these past weeks off and on, but the worst is yet to come. In a few days, though, I should be free. I'll head over to the followers and see if they'll help me through this.
Very nice. What is it that they say about like ditching like a very addictive habit? What is it that they say, like, the first 3 days are the hardest or something? What is that? I always forget what that statistic is. Anyway, we're gonna return to Julie.
Wanna get lucky? Head on down.
Oh my god, freaking girl. Good lord. Yeah, the Atomic Wrangler is quite the place. It's a bar where that's where the Garrett twins tend to.
We've got stuff we're not even allowed.
Julie,
to sell,
oh whoops. Julie very briefly touched upon them during our little talk. And there's something else. There's something else. They love getting people hooked on their alcohol, and they love supplying the town with cheap whores. It's a disgusting place, honestly. I would never want to hang out there. I would never want to hang out anywhere here. Where is Julie? Julie, where is she? I mean, it's nighttime. Oh, is she over, like, in her little side room here? She might be in her little side room. She totally is. This is her house, man, I guess. I guess it's her house. Oh, I need a light. Oop. Would it kill you to install some more lighting in here, Julie? Where are you? Oh, she's sleeping. Oh, this is awkward. Well, I'm just gonna take this snow globe. You found a limited edition Mojave Landmarks snow globe. These rare pre-war artifacts are widely considered to be useful baubles, but rumor has it some collectors will pay dearly for them. Whenever you see a snow globe in this game, pick them up. There is a particular collector in this game that will pay you like 2,000 caps each for them. Ooh, guess I can't steal that. Julie, wake up! Oh god, jeez. She was like, I had a terrible dream.
Hi, do you
need
assistance?
No. I helped out with the addiction problem.
I saw them.
No, you didn't.
You
were sleeping.
Thank you so much for helping them. This means a lot to the followers of the apocalypse. You have our thanks. If you need some medical supplies, come see me. With Jacob working with us, we should be able to spare a stim or fixer once a day.
Ooh, nice. Yeah, so doing this quest will give you a little bit of followers fame, a little bit of Freeside fame, and Julie.
Sure.
Ooh, God,
would
geez,
you like a stim
excuse
pack,
me.
Fixer,
Julie is able to spare some medical supplies every 24 hours. So you can either get a stim pack, a pack of fixer, or some rat away. I always choose a stim pack myself, but that's just me. It's always nice to have the choice of the rat away as well, because some areas, oh nice, I'm accepted in Freeside. Some places in Fallout New Vegas are very heavily irradiated. So make sure you have rat away. You know, make sure you wear your radiation suit, make sure you put on whatever that drug is called, Rad-X, that like raises your resistance to radiation.
Okay.
There is still some stuff that Julie would want us to do right now. That other thing. But she did already talk to us about something to do with like supplies from Mick and Ralph. So let's see if we can do something for them. Cause that would be cool. We've already seen them, you know, we've established that rapport with them. Our journalist instincts have established that relationship. So perhaps we can ask him some questions and get what we need. I'm assuming that we're gonna be talking to Mick. But maybe not. We might have to settle for Ralph. Okay. It's so sad. Dixon's just dead outside of, right outside their store door. Hope you guys never come out of here.
If you're looking for guns, talk to Mick. Otherwise, I've got a nice selection of general supplies.
Well, the followers are looking to set up a supply deal.
We don't have the stills and equipment to supply the amount of meds they're looking to purchase. We could check with other wasteland merchants, but I think your best bet would be the Atomic Wrangler. They've got a bunch of stills and a seemingly endless supply of grain alcohol, which could be used as anesthetic or disinfectant.
Wow. Geez, for owning just like a general store, you guys sure are pretty smart. Pretty cool guys. I do like it in here. It's a very... It's kind of a gross, grungy-looking place, but at the same time, I don't know. I don't know if it's the washing machines or what. There's just something very homey about this place. I like it. I guess it just reminds me of like a shitty hardware store.
Whoa. You're the one who's been going around helping people around here, right? The king says to keep up the good work. He said to give you this.
Thanks? Oh, okay, thank you. Barrel cactus fruit. It must be because of my... Must be because of my fame in Freeside. I'm now accepted. So now I'm getting gifts from the king, dude. The king. The king himself. We'll be talking to the king, perhaps in the next episode as well. I want these next few episodes to be used to kind of really get a taste of what all these different factions in Freeside are. Because like I said, there's a lot, like a lot. Like there must be 6 or 7 new factions
needs.
Just in this area, which is absolutely crazy. Let's go in here. He said we have no choice but to try out the Atomic Wrangler. So let's see if we can set up a deal with them. Ugh.
Make a brief stop at the Atomic Wrangler, where the booze is cheaper, the table's more friendly, and the women are just like the booze.
Oh my god. Oh my god. What a horrible place. Hey, Bill. Nice seeing you, buddy. Alright, is this dump? What? The front window is completely broken. This place is probably a piece of shit, if ever there was one. Wow, great. You know what's even, you know what I love more than this horrible looking place? This horrible looking place that makes my computer lag ever so slightly. Oh, that is awful. It's just because of the depth of field and the distance, because there's an extra room in the back there. Causes everything to lag. As long as I ain't looking at her. Alright, James Garrett. Yeah. How's it going, buddy? You look like a dirt bag.
Hey, chum. Welcome back.
I was never here. The followers need to find someone to trade with for supplies.
Really now? This is news. We could possibly supply what they need, but they would need to supply us in kind.
What?
They have the tech know-how to make our stills work more efficiently. Pure alcohol means we can get our customers drunk quicker.
This sounds like a horrible idea.
Getting our customers drunk quicker means more caps spent at the tables and stuffing slots, if you know what I mean. Plus, the extra alcohol can serve as surgical disinfectant for their needs. The followers are a good lot. They've stitched up our boys in the past.
This doesn't sound like a good idea.
Good. We can supply them with all the medics they need. For the fixer, we'll only be able to send over some basic drug components. We're not in the business of getting people off drugs, so we don't really dabble in that side of things. The followers should be able to whip some up with what we have available, though. They just need to agree to fix up our stills and keep them maintained, plus cover the cost for raw materials needed to make the alcohol.
Oh, God. I feel like I just made a contract with Satan. Does anyone else get that feeling that I just kind of dabbled with the devil for a second there? I think this is what hell looks like when you die and you've sinned. I think this is what hell looks like. Oh God, what am I gonna tell Julie? So what the deal is saying is, so he's going to supply us with like disinfectant and stuff, and like, you know, like very pure strong alcohol that can be used for such purposes.
If it can be bought, it can be found.
Oh my God. But they have to cover the costs so that they can still use. Oh God. Okay, we're back. Sorry about that cut I had to make. New Vegas crashed on me for absolutely no reason, so I had to get back to where I was. But it's no problem. The funny thing about New Vegas progress is that because of all the lore and dialogue we go through, and the fact that it can be like skipped and just clicked through, it actually makes catching up very, very easy. In episodes like this, at least. That's more or less lots of talking and filling in the gaps. We gotta go and tell. Oh God, I don't want to tell Julie. Julie, where are you? Oh, there you are.
Yep.
You're not in your little cubby this time. Hey, girl.
Welcome.
Hi. Okay. Frig. I don't want to tell her. I don't wanna. This seems like such an ass backwards approach to doing things. All right. I think I found someone who will be able to cover your supplies.
That's phenomenal. Who did you find?
The Garrett twins.
They supply Freeside with drugs and liquor. From my point of view, they're just better organized pushers.
Yeah.
Upgrading their stills would increase their supply of liquor and chems. How does that help Freeside?
It doesn't. Oh God. You can get your chems and help. Oh God, these are all horrible excuses. With a surplus of supplies, you can use your caps and influence to expand. They just need tech support and raw materials.
Good point. We wouldn't be paying anything for their supplies, just a portion of our food waste to make ethanol. We get food from nearby wasteland farmers in exchange for medical services, so we could put our caps back into helping Freeside.
Oh.
Tell the Garretts we'll keep their stills running if they provide us with supplies. Thank you for arranging this. You've been a godsend.
Hey, no problem. I still feel, I feel very dirty arranging that. I might have to do something about that. I don't know how. Is there a way I can fix that? I don't know. I don't think there is, but anyway, if I wanted to calm things down in Freeside, she also talked about how there's lots of tension going on around here. Where can I start to calm things down?
The big man around here is the King. Not much happens in Freeside that he doesn't know about.
Keep hearing that name.
He has the most influence locally, and some of his crew haven't helped the situation by harassing NCR citizens and charging double for water. Some NCR soldiers have been bringing in supplies, but none of it is going to Freeside locals. I've tried to speak to both sides to no avail.
Okay. Well, okay, let's try and do our part. I have some medical supplies to drop off.
Great. What do you have?
I have Med-X.
How much do you...
3.
Thanks. Anything else?
I have more. Oh, I'll donate 2 more.
Thanks. Anything else?
Right away.
How much do you have to donate?
I have much use for this stuff yet.
So thanks. Okay. Anything else?
That's all.
Thanks for the donation. Every bit goes toward helping Freeside.
I feel like I didn't do a whole lot, but hey, you know. You're welcome. Yay, I'm liked! Hey! I screwed you guys over and turned your Helios 1 thing into a weapon, but hey. At least you guys like me. Oh, I feel like such a joik. Ugh, I'm such a two-faced bitch. I'm such a bitch, Veronica. Oh my God. We're getting close to the mark that I would normally end an episode at. So let's end this episode with in the next episode, I think we're gonna go over to the Kings. I think we'll go over to the Kings. But let's talk to Veronica. Let's see what she has to say about some things.
You can't help but notice that the Brotherhood barely exists to these people out here. We're like an urban myth, no real presence on the outside.
We
just don't adapt like we should. Used to be that all you needed to get your way was a suit of power armor and a laser rifle. Now, people are armed and organized. They're not afraid. But we still stick to our old approach because it's all we know.
Oh, hey, Nintendo, what's going on? Power armor and laser rifles are still effective. The Brotherhood is living in the past. Eventually, they'll have to change. Or, if it's worked for this long, there must be something redeemable about their beliefs. Have faith. I don't know. I like to think a power armor and laser rifles are still effective, but I don't think they are, honestly. I don't know. Power armor is great. We won't see power armor until way later in the game, but holy shit, man. Power armor is something to behold. I don't know. Yeah, if it's worth... I like playing Devil's Advocate.
Wow, you sound like Elder McNamara. I know, I should. Hell, it's what I signed up for when I chose to stay into adulthood. I know there's something we're saving in there, but we're in decline. Our membership is decimated. There's got to be something we can do.
Why don't you tell me about yourself?
I like long walks in the desert and candlelit metal workshops.
You sarcastic son of a gun. What are your goals? This is a job interview. What are your objectives in life?
I want a dress.
Excuse me? Tell me something. I like how the other two are completely dismissive. I want to discuss other things. Okay, tell me about this dress you want.
Yeah, a good one. Something elegant and classy, you know? But still stylish. Something that's eye-catching and sexy, but also says, don't fuck with me. I keep hoping I'll come across some old-world designer gown when I'm scavenging, but it never happens. Maybe I should move back to California.
So that's what you want. You want a dress. A nice dress.
Hey, you try getting a date wearing scribe robes. Might as well be wearing sweatpants.
That's true.
I just like them, you know? They make you feel like a woman. Those ladies before the war, they knew what they were doing.
Oh, you know it. Tell me something else about you.
Can I make it up?
Okay. Yeah, I'll just completely ignore your sarcastic, douchey responses to everything. Is there some place you wanted me to take you? Well respected? Ever been in love? What is with this? We're doing some shipping here? Let's bite. Veronica! Ever been in love, Veronica?
Ever been nosy?
Ooh, okay.
I was, once. We were pretty young, but I like to think it was love.
Oh, what happened?
She left the Brotherhood. Wanted to put some distance between herself and her parents. Since our membership isn't open to outsiders, some members think that obligates all of us to procreate. You can guess which camp her parents belong to.
Oh my. Okay, well, it looks like we struck out. But hey, you know. If we belong to separate camps, that's okay. Just tell me more. Tell me more. What did she look like?
No. Couldn't bring myself to leave everyone else behind. Couldn't convince her to stay, either. I'd hoped love would be enough to influence her decision, but it wasn't. We were both too stubborn.
Oof.
I don't know where she is now, but I'm sure she's moved on. I still think about her, though. Once in a while.
Aw, jeez. Aw, Veronica, don't! Oh, let's keep moving. Yeah. Oh, God. I think I just put her in a pissy mood. It's like, oh, bringing up old love like that. Old love always bites, dude. It always stings. Stings like a bitch, doesn't it? Veronica. I'm crouching, so now she is. Okay, let's stand up. We're gonna end the episode right here. I hope you all have a very good life. We helped out the followers. We learned a little bit more about Veronica. Oh,
hey,
God.
You're the one who's been going around helping people around here, right? The king says to keep up the good work. He said to give you this.
Or afterlife. If you are a king's gang member. Just lying on the ground in the next episode. Oh, I'm just gonna let these guys just fight it out. I'll just see what happens. There we go. Look, I'm mixed now. A little bit good mixed with a little bit bad. People haven't figured me out. That's right. I'm Shadow the Hedgehog. I'm kind of a cool badass at times. You never really know if I'm a good guy or a bad guy. Oh, hey, cool, and I leveled up too. I'll do this off camera. Peace.